Hello, welcome to I Love Gay Today. And today we are in Las Vegas and we are here with Ricky Cornish. How are you, Ricky?
Oh my gosh, I'm doing so well, Matt. Thanks for hanging out with me today.
Well, this is fun. And, you know, and I will say, like, okay, so I've been in the LGBT media world for 27 plus years, 28 now that it's 2023. And I can honestly say that I love what I've been seeing from you, and it's inspiring because, you know, after all those years, it's interesting to be able to see kind of the future, or kind of a window into the future of where LGBT media and personalities and all of this is really going. And I think you bring a lot of that home.
Thank you so much. Well, I have to say, it really means the world getting support from people like you, because ever since I dived into the world of media, I've always wanted to just be myself. I think, especially as young journalists, we're taught that you have to just do things a certain way and you're never the story, right? It's all about like the person you're interviewing or the thing that you're working on. So the fact that I've been able to insert myself a little bit here and there, thanks to the shows I've been hosting, thanks to the interviews I've been doing, and thanks to TikTok, honestly. Yeah. I've just kind of built my own little path, I feel like, and getting support from people like you and all of my brothers and sisters in the LGBTQ plus community has seriously meant the world to me.
Oh, I love that. And yeah, like you're saying, you're out there. First of all, you're on KTNV Action News and you host, you know, part of the morning blend. I think that's amazing.
Thank you. Yeah, that is the wildest story, can I tell you? Because that's actually how I started in this industry. It was my first internship when I was in college. I went to the Walter Cronkite School of Journalism at Arizona State, and my first internship was at the Morning Blend here in Las Vegas. And, you know, I was just a typical intern, just helping out. But I remember when I was there, I was like, I kind of want to get on camera. I would love to get some stuff for my reel while I'm at this internship. And being such an amazing station and show that they are, they let me on camera. And man, if you were to find those clips online, Matt, you would cringe, like, so busted. I was barely making sense. It was just not cute. But they gave me that opportunity to go on air and kind of start this journey. So fast forward to today, I'm currently working at Out Magazine full time. Yep. And that show has been going through a lot of changes within the past few months. And they haven't quite narrowed down like who they're going to actually hire for their co-host. But given the fact that I have such history with that station, they called me up and said, hey, listen, like, we're figuring out a lot of things behind the scenes. We really need some help. Like, would you be able to just be on an on-needed basis, an on-call type of basis, to come in and help us out? And I was like, yeah, of course. So for the past few months, whenever they need me, I just go in and fill in and help host the show. And that's about it. But it's been such a fun experience. And TikTok has been loving it. So I can't.
But no, you've got, because I've seen some of the clips where, I mean, between Bravo TV and Drag Race. And I mean, you are really in the thick of it right now.
Oh my gosh, it's been so crazy, right? I'm always so grateful to every publicist that opens a door for me, every person who's willing to be interviewed by me, because it's been the wildest journey. Like, I started at this show called Celebrity Page TV, which isn't on the air anymore, but that was my first official job in this crazy entertainment world. And I started there in January 2020. And ever since then, I was just reaching out, building connections. And I'm thanks to everybody that I worked with on that show too, because they gave me the trust to go out and be on camera and try these different interviews and do all these different things. And because of that, I've just grown in this industry. And once I made the transition from Celebrity Page to Out Magazine, I've been able to bring a lot of those same contacts over. So now I keep doing all these really fun interviews. And now that we're finally, like, this is great that we're doing this virtually, but of course, a lot of things in person have come back too. So there's nothing like being on that red carpet or going to that premiere party or whatever it may be and just having a blast.
No, well, obviously, you're famous now with the Gay Vienne Awards.
Oh, my gosh. Somebody sent me a DM the other day that said, you're gamest. And I almost fell out of my chair. I thought that was actually hysterical. Gamest. Oh, my gosh. That was like the wildest experience ever, because a lot of people have asked me, like, what was your, like, did you have a strategy? Did you plan that? Like, did you just go for it when you were on the red carpet? And honestly, the truth is, I did have a little bit of a strategy. Like, when I was going in to cover this, first off, shout out to Out Magazine for letting me even go and cover the Gay Vienne Awards. But I'm on that red carpet and I had plans. Like, we're at the Gay Vienne Awards. Let's do something that's going to be at least unique, different, something that can be a little special to this award show. And hence, the kissing competition was born. And shout out to all the amazing adult entertainers that were willing to participate in that kissing competition. And yeah, once I came home, I just was like, all right, let's splice and dice and edit this together. I do all my own editing myself. So I edited it together, posted it, and the rest is history.
Oh, and history it is. I was at brunch and showed some folks. It's like, oh, I'm going to be interviewing him this week. And have you seen this video? Everyone had seen that video. I was like, I can't believe you all have seen this.
It's crazy. I can't believe how many people have seen it as well. Like once it started going on Instagram, because I hadn't posted it to my Instagram, like one of my outlets that I work for had tweeted it out. So it was on Twitter, going crazy on Twitter, and my phone's blowing up and I'm like, I don't know what to do with this. Like, this is crazy. Then Instagram, all the incredible like meme accounts on Instagram started posting it. And that's when I feel like it really went everywhere, because the amount of times I was getting DMs from people I didn't know, people I did know, like yeah. It was crazy. I actually just did a press junket the other day. The journalists in the holding room with me knew who I was, and one of them said that they talked about me on his podcast. Like, I was like, what is happening? It's crazy.
I was, you know, it's great too. You know, there's a context to this because 20 years ago, I used to start going to the GAVN Awards, and the GAVN was new because there was always the AVN, and then all of a sudden there was GAVN. And I went there because the porn industry was just at the cutting edge of streaming video online. And that was like something very new. And I wanted to learn more about it for more mainstream LGBT video. And plus they had amazing parties. So when I started just going there, I discovered like, oh my God, what have I been missing? So I used to go year after year to the GAVN Awards and some of the shows.
Oh my gosh, it's so much fun. And I love that you mentioned mainstream, because that was the thing that really hit home for me when I was interviewing some of these people, you know, when they were saying, we are just so excited that you're here representing Out Magazine. Like, that's incredible. And I'm like, I know, like, it's amazing to see that we're in this time where more mainstream media are covering all things that affect us in our community, all things that represent us. And whether if you like it or you don't, it is part of our community. There are people who resonate with the things that they're doing, and they are inspired by a lot of the things that they're doing as well. So meeting so many of them, they all were so lovely, and seeing that we are giving them that platform to shine the way they should, is it really means everything. It was such a great opportunity.
Yeah, I agree. It's more honest. It's more honest reflection of who we are, and not having to hide some, you know, these sides. It's not what everyone's into, but a good portion just loves some of those stars.
Absolutely. And it's like, I think you should be giving them a platform. I know for me, like when it came to me coming out and getting more comfortable with my sexuality, a lot of that content made me feel more comfortable about myself. I always say all the time, like when you're growing up, you, especially in the LGBTQ community, you don't get an education on how to live. You're not shown proper representation on how you get to live a great life and have a great job and find a partner and like, or whatever makes you feel good. Like none of that is really represented, and we're getting a little bit better as the years go by, but there's still so much work that needs to be done. And I think about just the fact that I was able to do even cover this red carpet, let alone the viral video, I think is a step in the right direction. So I'm excited to see what might come from this.
I'm excited to see where all this goes. I mean, where do you go from here?
That's the biggest question, right? I don't know. It has been the wildest month ever, because not only did I go viral for this video, I've also been doing a lot of amazing things at my full-time job. So not only do I work for Out Magazine, I work for a slew of LGBTQ magazines. So The Advocate Magazine, HIV Plus Magazine, Pride.com, Out Traveler. I work for all of those magazines full-time. And I actually had my first two covers come out this month, which was incredible. So I'm assuming you've seen Mean Girls, you know, Jonathan Bennett.
Oh, yeah.
So I interviewed him and his husband, James Vaughn, who I love, on their travel company called Outbound. And that was the cover story for the January/winter issue of Out Traveler. So that just came out last week. And then literally today, as we're talking, the cover story just came out with Cheyenne Jackson for The Advocate. And I also wrote that story as well. So to have my first two cover stories for national magazines come out the same month that I went viral for kissing some people at the GAVNs is mind-blowing.
I'm looking forward to all this. I don't live there. I'm from LA, moved to New York, and now I kind of live in the general New York area. But I travel a lot, been to Vegas more times than I can count, and look forward to connecting in the real world. Maybe it'll be Vegas Pride or something along those lines.
Please. I actually just hosted the last Las Vegas Pride. We have it in October because, you know, Over the summers, it's brutal out here. So We need to cool down a little bit. So yes, please. Anybody who's watching or anybody that like is looking to connect, just send me a DM. My Instagram DMs are open. Like I love connecting with my brothers and sisters in this community. There is nothing that makes me happier like being in Vegas and I go to Drag Race Live or I go to Piranha, like our biggest gay nightclub here, the Fruit Loop. Yeah. And people come up to me and they're like, oh my gosh, like, I love your stuff. I love your TikToks. I love your content. Like, cause you know, that's something I never thought would ever happen to me doing the things that I get to do. So meeting you guys and meeting everybody out there is like the cherry on top when it comes to the work that I do.
I love this. Well, thanks so much for being here and sharing just a little bit of your story with our audience. And like I said, look forward to connecting in the real world soon.
Yes. Well, thank you for taking the time to reach out to me, and hopefully we'll stay connected, and just follow me on everything at Ricky Cornish. That's where the party started, people.
You got it. Thanks again.
Thank you.
I know some people out there that cut out sugar entirely.
Yep, me too.
Genuine question, what do you eat? How do they do that? How do you cut out sugar entirely? Like, it's in fruit, it's in treats, it's in like so much. Like, how do you cut out sugar?
You could be the first Rue girl to bring the crown home as a Vegas queen. How humbling would that be? And how crazy does that picture even seem to you at this moment?
The possibility to have the shot at the crown is like everything. And you're right, we haven't had a Vegas winner yet. Emphasis on yet. And that's all I am going to say.
I met Ricky when I was 18, which was last year.
Exactly. So I have to ask you a question regarding my growth. Yes. On a scale of 1 to 10, how would you rate my eyebrows?
Okay. As the person with the most perfect eyebrows in Hollywood, I would say it's a solid 8. Okay?
All you gotta do is kiss me. That's the only rule. Wow. Very aggressive, which we love.
There it is. That's the one.
Is that something you would like to enter tonight, Roman?
Sure thing.
Okay, can I say, you automatically win for squatting.
I like to be on the same level.
I love it.
Thank you.
Are you kidding? Thank you. I won. I don't know who wins tonight, but I